Good morning. Today we will have complementary genes. What is meant by complementary genes? They are genes which complete the work of each other. Why? To make a trait appear. How this will happen? For example, if we take one trait like the flower in pea plant, the flower in pea plant, we have two colors, the dominant trait.
Both of them.
them are parents. So we want the gametes. How can we get the gametes? Each one of these two genes will take one of these two genes. So we will have A capital B small, A capital B small. Each one of the two genes will take one of these two genes. So we will have A small B capital, A small B capital. We call them gametes. First generation, how can we get first with first? So we will have A capital A small, B capital B small. Second with second. So we will have again A capital A small, B capital B small. What is the color of the flower in these plants? It will be purple color. What is the ratio for this generation? Ratio will be 100%. All of the plants will have the dominant character, which is the purple color. You see, the two parents are recessive. The two parents have the white color. But when we make crossing, they produce the first generation. All of them have purple color with a ratio 100%. So what will happen if we let those plants make self-pollination with each other? Or what will be the result if they make a crossing with each other? We will see if we take the gametes. If we took the gametes, they will be. Here we have four different letters. Each one of these two genes should take these two genes. So what will be the gametes? Will be like this. A capital, B capital. A capital, B small. A small, B capital. A small, B small. Again, the same, the other side for the other plant. A capital, B capital. A capital, B small. A small, B capital. A small, B small. To get the second generation, we should make a table because we will have 16 individuals in the second generation. So the table will be like this.
Second gamete with the same row. It will be A capital A capital.
white. Because we didn't have dominant gene from the other group. So this will, this A capital A small, B capital B small, purple. Again, this will this A capital A small, B small, B small, this will be white. Again, we will take this with all of those. A capital A small, B capital B capital, purple. A capital B small, B capital B small, purple. A small, B capital will be white. Why? We have here two dominant genes, okay, but they are from the same group. We should at least have one dominant gene from this group with another dominant gene of this group. So the last one will be A small, B capital B small, also will be white. The last one will be A capital A small, B capital B small, purple. Here, A capital A small, B small, B small, white. Here, A small, B capital B small, white. Here, A small, B small, B small, also will be white. We want to know the ratio for the second generation. We have here the ratio of the first. We want to know the ratio of the second generation. So we should count from our table the number of the plants which have purple color in the flower and the other plants which have the white color. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So we have 9 purple. Okay, for how much white? This is number 1, number 2, this is number 3, number 4, number 5, number 6, number 7. So we have 7 white. We want to analyze the results. We are giving 2 plants with the recessive trait, which is the white color for the flower. But the first generation, by 100%, we get the dominant color, which is the purple color. And in the second generation also, we have mild purple, which is the dominant, 2, 7 white, which is the recessive. So what happened? What happened is each group of the dominant genes, if at least we have one gene from this group and one gene from this group, each gene controls the production of an enzyme. The two enzymes are working together. They complete the work of each other to make the dominant trait, which is the purple color, appears. What is the difference between this case, which is complementary genes, with the second Mendelian law, which was concerning the inheritance of two different characters with each other? There, in Mendel law, we have a different ratio, which was, if you remember, 9, 2, 3, 2, 3, 2, 1. But here we have 9, 2, 7. So here we have 2 traits, but here we have 1 trait only. Here we didn't have enzymes to share each other in appearing the traits. Here we have 2 enzymes to make the dominant.